Well, welcome and good evening, you wonderful dice of all alignments. I am Lunar D8, and I wanted to play Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. It was on sale. I bought it. And I had to do questionable things to my computer. Sexually inappropriate things to my computer. To make this even boot. By that I mean, I kept trying to relaunch this game like 7 times. And then I found that if I just keep clicking on the little icon and bringing up the, the black screen, and then if I did small semicircles with my index finger on my trackpad, it would keep it loading a moment longer. And after repeating that like 50 times, for like 10 minutes, eventually, I got the game to actually load into the start menu. However, as I looked through the graphics settings, as it's set to a full screen, and I can't seem to get OBS to capture a full screen because I don't know what the hell I'm doing, but there is no option to change out of full screen into windowed mode. And I tried the whole holding shift and enter thing to try to force it to do that. Nope, that's not a thing. And, yeah. So, I can't record it. That's shit. So much for being a Sith Lord. And doing and being evil across the universe. I remember this being a really good game, and of course I could still. Well, I don't know. I don't want to do that whole song and dance every time I want to try to boot this damn thing up. But this is a good game. Just for whatever reason, I can't play it. So disappointing. Semicircles? Semicircle. I don't know if you can hear the music. Let me see if I can at least start up a new game. Maybe there might be some option. Cannot use controller at all. Okay. I can be scavenger, scout, or soldier. Yeah, I'm just gonna click soldier. Just where is I can't. We're just doing a quick character. Just gonna hop into it, go with default everything. Cause maybe there's an additional menu. A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. Knights of the Old Republic. 4,000 years before the rise of the Galactic Empire, the Republic verges on collapse. Darth Malak, last surviving apprentice of the Dark Lord Revan, has unleashed an invincible Sith armada upon an unsuspecting galaxy. How did they not suspect this? Crushing all resistance, Malak's War of Conquest has left the Jedi Order scattered and vulnerable as countless knights fall in battle and many more swear allegiance to their new Sith Master. In the skies above the Outer Rim, world of Taurus, I wanted to say Tetris there for a second, the Jedi battle fleet engages the forces of Darth Malak in a desperate effort to halt the Sith's galactic domination. Also, very questionable sizing options for this cutscene. It's like, you have me locked into full screen, and yet there is like an inch thick border of black all around our theatrical. It's like, is that necessary? You think they just made it bigger? Why would you size it this way? Why would you lock me into full screen? Why would you not give me an option to change the size? I saw OBS freak out there for a second. Why is the sizing for this so weird?
Hurry up, we don't have much time. I'm Traskel. Now hurry up. We have to. Bastil is the command. One of our prime. I've heard all about where it is, the office. We're soldiers. So hurry up and.
Trying. Okay,
to the edges of the screen,
in case you guys are curious, that devolved into something really dumb.
The right mouse button will rotate the camera as well.
Because what I was doing is, at first I was like, I found a way to go to the menu, I moved with the WASD keys, and then I was like, okay, M can bring up a menu, a map.
To move towards the footlocker, hold down the right mouse button,
and then Q and E could let me move around inside
the
menu.
Hold down the left mouse button as well.
Then I just sort of started tapping everything. Then, I'll be honest, I started moving both of my hands on my keys like this. I don't know if you guys can hear this.
You can left click on an object to select.
But right now, I am moving in very large concentric circles with both my hands mashing my keys on my laptop. I'm basically, like, my left hand is going clockwise, my right hand is going counterclockwise. And the moment I started doing this, I started realizing it's like I'm playing with nipples. Like I'm pretending my laptop is titties. Now just place my entire palm on the keyboard.
Move the mouse to the edges of the screen to rotate.
I am attempting to fondle my keyboard as if it's titties. But it is very flat. My keyboard is very flat. That being said, I know there's ergonomic keyboards. Is there a key? Are there keyboards in the shape of boobs? Like, I understand there's like those boob mouse pads and memory foam that's supposed to be good for your wrist. But like, and like there's those odd, like gamer, like, and my phone's ringing for some reason. Are there keyboards in the shape of boobs? Would that be ergonomic?
You can left click on an object to select it. Once the footlocker is selected, left click on it again to perform the default action and open it.
I'm not sure if there's any more sexually inappropriate things I could do with my laptop. And I mean, it's a fairly, you know, it's a laptop. It's not like the old computers. Because at least if you had the old school computers back in the age of Windows 95 and AOL startup, back when you couldn't use a phone because, you know, your internet used your phone line, and of course it made that fax sound. You know, you guys remember fax machines, right? You know that fax machine noise when it connected to like Earthlink or whatever? You know, AOL 95 Windows, you know, prehistoric age. Like, it would make the You know, it's like every time you wanted to connect to the internet, it was like, oh, it's either angry robots, like, oh, what sound does the internet make? Oh, it's just angry robots screaming, or just having very loud, very, very loud inappropriate sex. And Shit! Where are my laptops? Angry at me! Not like it physically did anything to me, but apparently I'm having a psychosomatic response to how fucking cringy I am. God damn it. My entire right leg fucking cramped up. My right foot is not. It's like the muscle over top of my ankle in my right foot is like moved out of place. It almost feels like my ankle doesn't want to be in my foot anymore. Which I don't blame it, but I need you, ankle. Stay in your home. Fuck. God damn it. Fucking muscle spasm cramp, whatever you are. God damn it. Fuck, that hurts. You guys ever have that thing where, like, you know, a muscle over your ankle kind of moves out of place, and then a cramp goes up your entire fucking calf like a really bad Charlie horse, and your three little toes, your foot kind of pop out of socket for a moment? Just me! Well, fuck everyone! Not funny! God damn it! I'm still saying my joke. Yes, I was in the middle of a joke. That's what the fucking robot angry sex was about. When I talked about how the internet was just robots screaming at you, and people are gonna think we're fucking crazy in the middle of it. Not that that's not true. Already the case. But still, I'm just saying, you guys remember. Like stuff like Oregon Trail and shit like that. But don't you dare fucking do it again. What are you thinking about it? Don't you do it. Don't you do it. I'm massaging you. Don't you try to kill me, but I'm looking at you. But I'm just saying, like, you guys remember how, like, the internet was, like, robots screaming at you? Could you imagine telling people in the future about that? Oh, yes, in my day, when the internet first existed, it took an hour to log on, and it was through the phone line. And when you used it, no one could talk on the phone. Cell phones didn't exist. You know, we're like one step above a fucking rotary phone, and pay phones were everywhere. We had to put quarters in order to be able to talk to people for a couple fucking minutes. Does any place even still have fucking payphones? Because I could swear, I think it was like 2005 or so, they started ripping all the fucking payphones out. And I think by 2011, I don't think there were any payphones. I gotta remember where they were in the past, but I think even by 2011, which is over a decade ago,
all signs that a payphone had ever existed and wiped out. You have to, like, fucking watch, like, the original Superman movie to see that shit. Like, and people be like, oh, Superman hops in a payphone in order to change his outfit. And people be like, what the fuck's a payphone? What the fuck's a phone that's not a cell phone? I still remember back in 2011. I don't think I was able to start texting until 2012. And even then, it was like a shitty flip phone where you had like, I'd be like, 7777. That's the letter S. Doo, doo, doo. And even then, that was like, yeah. Really, it's a long way. I'm just saying, I remember like the internet being robots screaming at you. And you had to wait half an hour to like download a single picture of tits. And it was like, what's on the internet? Well, not only did Facebook not even exist, and YouTube didn't exist, but even their predecessors. What the? How did you mispronounce that name? Even their predecessors. You dumbass. Like Facebook. No, MySpace. MySpace didn't fucking exist. Whatever existed before MySpace didn't exist. It was literally just, you know, basic fucking websites with no decorations or anything. It was just, hey, there's a chat room. Hey, here's instructions on how to, like, fix your sink and shit. You know? If you were on the internet, it was either you just a person trying to research something for a paper, or you're the fucking government. I mean, it's kind of like cell phones. If you had a high-end cell phone back when they were a thing, when cell phones started existing, it meant that you were rich, and you were like a major business person who would like, you know, like you were rich. Like if you had cell phones when they first started coming out, especially the early version of the iPhone, I mean, you were probably like a fucking CEO or some shit, or a famous movie actor. But back to the horrible joke that I psychosomatically tried to prevent myself from, you know, doing. Old computers. Here's another thing that you guys, nobody's gonna fucking remember. Floppy disk drives. Here's the dirty joke. 3.5-inch floppy disk drive. Ha! Huh. But, just think about early video games. Back then. Early Nintendo and Atari. Oh, Pac-Man! Yeah, you're a circle, and you run around and eat other circles. And then there's ghosts! But then you eat a big circle, and then you eat them! That actually sounds more sexual than my jokes. But then there's fruit! Because there's grapes and oranges and cherries and shit. Or Pong! You're a stick! You bounce a ball! That's actually like a square into another stick. Asteroids, you're a triangle. And you're killing all of the abominations that can't actually be proper geometry. Oh yeah, what's Mario? Oh, you're a plumber. And you have to save the Mushroom Kingdom by eating mushrooms that make you bigger. And then you eat flowers and you breathe fire. And you have to save the princess of the Fungus People, you know, from an evil dinosaur who has a big dick. And then there's lava, but it's Pepsi. And then there's Leonard Nimoy with a laser gun. And then you get a star, and then hyper music plays. And then, you know, you become the Sith for a while. And some of the mushrooms are different colors. And heck, there's a glitch where on that little climby platform, a pyramid of brown blocks, you know, because limited color palettes for NES, which still, I love the NES. It was so much fun. I still say Dragon Spirit, absolute greatest game ever made for the NES. It's a shmup, it's a vertical scroller, it's incredible. And for 8-bit music, oh, it's amazing. And you have Robo Warrior, second best game ever made. other honorable mentions, of course, of things like Legend of Zelda, Mario, Castlevania. Though I'd care more for Science Games, which Castlevania 2. Or Swords and Serpents, for anyone who's a fan of Dungeons and Dragons. Or, you know, Mazes, Labyrinths. There's Waldo. Cybac, the person who's inspired by the I Want to Be the Guy game. But still, remember watching Agent J on Cloud 8745, Hypersonic X2, play Battle Kid, and it was just not good. Well, they probably did that too. I mean, I Want to Be the Guy. But yeah, there's Battle Kid, which is made by Cybac. Battle Kid 1, Fortress of Peril, and then Battle Kid 2, Now in the Torment, which the first one released in 2010 for NES. Well, it's most popular get that for Bob for the emulators. He did actually make it for physical fucking cartridges. I'm sure you can still buy it. And of course the sequel, the second one, released in 2012. I still say Cybac. And again, I challenge Nintendo. Please release Super Mario World and why can't I fucking talk? And Pokemon games on Steam. I think that'd be awesome. Like, I'd be able to do... Like, here's the thing. I could do so much shit with Mario, because Super Mario World is an amazing game. It still is. I think it stands since then. I think it's one of those platformers everyone in the world needs to play. Here's the thing. Here's the most amazing thing about Super Mario World. You can play the game multiple times yourself, but then you can go back through and do other things, like, can you do it with no power-ups? Well, there are some stages you can. Can you do it without switches? Can you do it without picking up any points? Can you beat the entire game without using sith? Can you beat the entire game without dying? Can you hold run the whole time? Can you do only spin jumps? Can you beat the game by holding down? Because here's that heavenly move. Holding down and over in a direction. You can still move with jumps. But yeah, you wouldn't be able to run or anything or get momentum. And of course, there might be some spots we have to, like you need to run up one of those, you know, triangle, dead Super Meat Boy, Bandage Girl blocks, and you know, just sort of treadmill them like you're just beating Kirby in the face. But Kirby's pretty awesome. Metroid. Yeah, and then, like I said, when you go to Super Mario 3, it's like, oh yeah, now there's turtles that throw hammers, and Princess got bigger boobs, and there's an angry sun! Oh yeah, I started talking about a glitch in the first game with pyramid blocks. In Super Mario 1, when you're trying to go to that flagpole, you want that pyramid thing, staircase, what you can do is you can, there's a turtle going down it, and you can jump on the turtle over and over, but what you do is do it where it's right next to the edge of the block on that staircase, so that you just keep jumping on it, where you don't stop jumping on the turtle. And eventually, once you get enough points, it starts giving up your mind. So eventually, you glitch out the system, and it's like, it starts using letters and symbols and shit. So eventually, oh, how many lives do you have? Oh, you now have green level lives. Now green level lives. You now have sky blue level lives. Like, it literally goes through, like, fucking hands. Like, you know, poker hands. You know, like, you know, the ace, the jack, the king, queen. I feel like I'm forgetting one. Joker? Probably. But it's just like, it was hilarious. I don't know how many lives I lost. Anyway, I'm going to end this video here. I was watching more of the Markiplier in Space Part 2 again. It's just, I feel Markiplier, your in space thing, movie of the year, man. It is so fucking amazing. It's, granted, anybody who hasn't watched it, definitely watch Part 1 first. And by watch Part 1, I mean literally try to watch every possible route in Part 1. Before you watch any Part 2. But it's just movie of the year, man. Movie of the year. It's amazing. That's just gonna say this. I want to see Mark Flyer play the rage game splashing. Yes, I'm calling it a rage game. And I want to see Markiplier play Skullface. He did before again, and it's a lot of fun. Well, you want the Elder Turn. But I have a tendency to try to do like 50 different ones. And I want to see Markiplier play the platform Jubilee. But most of all, I want to see Markiplier play the Duke Gore of the Perfect Apocalypse Trilogy. First game is Love and Fight. Second game is Purgatory Forever. Third game is Patches Inferno. I played all three games live. I started with the second one, Purgatory Forever. And honestly, and here's the, yes, there is some violence. Like, if you want to have an idea what you need to, think Happy Tree Friends. But it's just maybe a little bit dialed down from that. But it is violent. People do die. It's a horror game. But it's also so cute and adorable. And the art style is amazing. And the story's actually really good. And the characters are just so fucking awesome. And I want to see Markiplier's reaction to everything they've done. Plus they have all sorts of secrets, endings, Easter eggs. And just, it's great, the perfect pocket. And yes, all of it is cat parts. But then again, that shouldn't surprise anyone that that would be something that would strike my fancy. I wrote a parody of Sweet Dreams where it's about Nekos. Because I love Nekos. Okay? Yeah, perfect fucking joke. Okay, the screen started warbling in the air. The ship rolling. But yeah, I'm gonna spend it now, I guess. As long as ABS doesn't, you know, hate me too much. I'm sorry, OBS! First smartphone! But anyway, I hope all of you had a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful day. Bye.